Hello there! In this video, we're going to show you how to get your Mini of the Month painted. This month is an absolute treat, as it is the new and fantastic looking Deathwing Terminator. All you have to do to pick up this model for free is make your way to your local Warhammer store. We're going to show you how to get your Deathwing Terminator painted quickly and easily using just 10 paints. The paints we'll be using are on the screen right now. These colors are perfect for getting your Deathwing Terminator looking awesome and ready to take on all foes of the Imperium in the name of the Lion. We also have a list of the additional equipment we've used, but you can use whatever brushes you feel most comfortable with. If you're new to painting or want to brush up on your skills, you can check out the Citadel Color Painting Essentials videos to learn all about our paints and painting techniques. Right, we've sprayed our model with Wraithbone spray to give us a nice light base coat to work from. We've also got a pot of Wraithbone to hand when we need to do any tidy ups during the process. Let's get painting. For our first paint, we'll cover all over the armor with Seraphim Sepia. Do one section at a time before moving on to the next. Check for pooling and soak up any excess with dry bristles. Once completely dry, do another layer towards the bottom of the legs, underside of the arms, and towards the bottom of the shield. This will give some nice depth to our shade, as well as act as subtle weathering. Let the model dry completely before moving on to the next step. This will most likely take between 10 to 15 minutes. Once the previous step has completely dried, we're now going to lightly dry brush Pallid Wych flesh all over the armor. Don't worry about hitting the other details, as we'll be rebasing them after the next step. Try to focus the dry brush towards the edges and raised areas of the armor and remember to keep it light. This will help to avoid unwanted texturing and a dusty effect. If you want to know more about dry brushing, you can check out our Painting Essentials video all about it. With that first dry brush done, we're now going to do a super light dry brush of white scar, picking out the most raised edges of the armor. This will really help to make the armor pop out nicely. When that's complete, we're now going to pick out the parchment, feathers, lenses, and crux terminatus with white scar as well. With all the white details done, we're now going to rebase the robes and any other details with Wraithbone, setting us up for the next paints. Awesome! Our armor is complete and we've set ourselves up nicely with the other details for later on. We're now going to carefully pick out the green robes with Dark Angels green straight from the pot. We'll take our time doing this as we don't want to get any on the armor. If we do, we'll just tidy back up with the previous steps. Dark Angels green contrast paint is fantastic and captures the dark and mystic green of the chapter so well. With that done, we're now moving on to using Blood Angels Red, heresy I know, to pick out the emblem, leather, shield, and lenses. Again, this is straight from the pot. We're letting the contrast do all the work for us with the highlights, pulling away from the edges to give us an easy highlight. Same as with the previous step, we'll take our time with this and try to be as neat as possible. Now we need to add a bit of color variation, and we'll be using Magos Purple to pick out the purple rope as well as the wax of the purity seals. It's a quick and simple step, but adds a lot to the model. We're moving on to doing the ribbing in between the armor next, and for this we'll be using Black Templar straight from the pot. It's a very dark contrast, so just be careful going around the armor again. Once we've done the armor, we need to pick out the weapon handles as well. All right, we're almost done. We're going to move on to our metallics next. For our first metallic, we're going around picking out all of the gold trim using Retributor Armour. Just remember to thin it out with a little bit of water. It's always best to do multiple thin layers than one thick layer. We can find these on the shield, skulls, shoulder pad, belt, crossguard, and trinkets. When that's complete, shade the gold with Seraphim Sepia. Next, we'll be picking out the silver details with Leadbelcher, again just thinning it out with a bit of water. We'll be focusing on the sword, vents on the back, and little details here and there. You can always check out the box art if you're confused as to where these are. When that is done, we'll then use Blood Angels Red to pick out the power nodes on the sword. For our final paint, we'll use Nuln Oil to shade our metallics, crux terminatus, parchment, feathers, as well as the red details. We'll do the silver metallic details first, shading all over them and trying not to get it on the armor. If you do get any on the armor, just tidy up with the previous steps. Once that is done, we need to pick out the parchment, crux terminatus, red details and feathers with thinned Nuln Oil. To do this, we'll just add some water to a 1-to-1 ratio so it's not as strong and thus gives us a more subtle shade. All that's left to do is add the transfers and base them. And there we go, our Deathwing Terminator is complete and ready to hunt down the fallen and vanquish all foes in the name of the Lion. We've based him to match the rest of our army. If you want to know more about basing, you can check out our Painting Essentials videos all about it. For more tutorials, tips and tricks, check out our videos on the Warhammer YouTube channel, or you can head to your local Warhammer store where our amazing staff will be more than happy to help. Well, we hope you've enjoyed this video and we'll see you again soon. Bye-bye.